asking him to forgive you and to save you, literally to adopt you as a child of God. That is the gift of Christmas. For God so loved the world that he gave, this is the reason why we give. You're the reason. God so loved you that he gave you for the only son. Before we continue in our service, if that's you, if you have never received a gift, we want to give you that opportunity right now. And Lord, I would pray with you, just pray this simple prayer of faith. Jesus, I do believe you're the Son of God. I believe that you died on the cross to pay for my sin and the sins of the whole world. I confess to you that I'm a sinner. I've said and thought and done things that are wrong. And I ask you to forgive me. And Jesus, right now, I'm forsaking all of that. I'm walking away from that life, that sin. Me in charge, I'm walking away from all of that. And by faith, I'm receiving the gift that you offer, forgiveness and new life. Jesus, adopt me to be a child of God. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for the Christmas gift. And Jesus, show me now, from this moment forward, how to live in a way that pleases you. Thank you for loving me. Thank you, Jesus, for forgiving me, for saving me. Amen. I want to remind you, as you go home and you have your Christmas Eve and tomorrow morning, keep Jesus in the center of Christmas. On your bulletin that was passed out to you, the Christmas story from Matthew is there. You don't read that, no matter whether or not you have children.